I try to be patient, but they just keep running around.
And of course, yelling always makes things better, doesn't it?
But they won't focus. All they can think about is food.
They are dogs, you know.
I guess.
No, really. I'm pretty quite sure they are.
Yeah, just smell their breath.
I know they're dogs.
Well, that's good. You had me worried for a minute.
I'm sorry. I just get so frustrated and then I get angry.
And when you get angry, you start slamming doors and yelling and saying things you wish you hadn't?
Yeah, I know.
You know, I was the same way when I was your age. In fact, I was much worse.
What?
Yeah, I was a pretty mean kid.
That's impossible.
No, believe it or not, some might even call me a bully.
No way. A man and I were just saying you're one of the nicest people we know.
It's right, Uncle Harmy. You really are.
Well, that's because of God, not me.
Really?
Yeah, just like Paul in the Bible. I was radically changed. Just ask your mom sometime. She'll tell you how mean I was.
I can't believe it.
Neither can I.
Well, it's true. I was as mean as they come. Then a friend gave me a Bible. And for a long time, it just sat on my coffee table. But then one day I asked myself, what did he see in that? What did he find that was so interesting? I had to know.
So you read it?
Yeah. I started reading, and I read and read and read. 5 whole days. I did nothing but eat, sleep, and read that Bible. And when I, at the end of the 5th day, I had read it through from beginning to end.
Really?
Yeah. And by that time, I could tell that God was using the Word to change me. I thought to myself, this is no ordinary book. This is the Word of God, and I need to obey it. I repented of my sin and believed that Jesus died on the cross and rose from the grave, paying the penalty for my sin. God saved me and gave me eternal life. And He's been changing me ever since to be more like Jesus. Now I want to show my love for Him by obeying His Word. So you see, the Bible's had an incredible impact on my life.
And that's why you love it so much.
That's right, Amanda. I do love the Bible.
Wow. Now you've got me curious. I think I'm going to go read about Paul.
Me too.
Father, as I approach your throne of grace, Father, I thank you for this opportunity. Lord, I thank you for touching Amanda and Alex's heart. Father, I just ask that you would encourage them. Give them the strength and the wisdom that they would need to understand your word. Father, make it real to them. Father, whoever may listen to this prayer, Father, might they know that your precious son died on the cross at Calvary for them too. Lord, we love you and we thank you and we praise you. We give you all praise and honor and glory in our lives. It's in your precious son's name we do humbly pray. Amen.